Hey everybody, this is Nick, and welcome back to our mini-series on how to make this really fun visual infographic all inside of PowerPoint. So again, thank you to the Visual Capitalist over on Instagram. We are using their design, their infographic, to sort of remake their design here inside of PowerPoint. So I want to give them credit. You'll link to their post above and below. Definitely go check out their page. They do a ton of great data viz stuff. So in lesson number 7, what we're going to focus on is creating the pins for the map. And each of these is going to be made in a custom fashion. And I'm going to slip over to this slide right here. In our last lesson, we added cities to the United States map. It's a real map chart type, the filled map chart. We added cities to those using the geography data type. And it might be kind of difficult to see here, but you can kind of see the little red dots where the cities are. Now, we are making this, we're adding this map to the slide just for visual reference so that I can put those custom pins pretty much where those cities are. It doesn't need to be exact for the purposes of this infographic. So that's kind of why we were going with that technique. So the map is on top of here. We're going to add some shapes. We're going to put those right on top of the map. So let me escape out of this slide and let's go ahead and think about making our custom map pins. So what we're going to do is first we're going to insert an icon. Go to the insert tab, go to the icons, and I'm going to actually search for location pins. Let's see what happens. Yeah, right here. Here's my location pin right here. Now this is a little bit different than the ones that I see in sort of my map visual. Those are more solid and this one has that sort of hole in it. So I'm going to actually make a custom shape using this map. And let's go ahead and map pin. So let me just make it a little bit bigger so that we can see. I'll zoom in here so that we can see this. Now what I'm going to do, since this is an icon, it's an SVG graphic, we can go ahead and right click and I'm going to go ahead and say convert to shape. We're going to convert this to a PowerPoint shape. So convert that to a shape. You can see the borders go away, and now we just have this PowerPoint shape. Now the shape format tab menu has popped up there, so we know it's a shape, and we know that we can edit it, and we can edit the colors and things like that. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another shape here. I'm going to go ahead, insert a circle. And I'm going to put this circle over the pin, and I really just want it to fill the size of that little donut hole there in the pin. So we're going to go ahead and change the color to black. I'm going to make sure that there's no outline here. If you wanted an outline, make sure that it's black as well to keep the same color. I'm going to go ahead and push the shift key and just make this a little bit smaller, put this right on top. And what we're going to do is go ahead and highlight both of them, hold down shift, highlight both of those, select both of those shapes, and we're going to use the merge shapes tools. So I have this on my quick access toolbar right here, and I'm going to go ahead and we're going to click on union. And when we union, that makes both of those shapes come together as one shape. So now this is just one PowerPoint shape that I can go ahead and work with. Now, the cool thing about shapes, remember, is that each shape in PowerPoint or Word or Excel, they're actually effectively their own miniature Word documents. You can type inside of them and you can adjust paragraph, the indentations and all that good stuff right inside a shape. So this is where I'm going to go ahead and just type my number one. So you can see number one here. I want it to be our font that we use. We didn't use the default font. We were using this band shrift, I think. Let's see if this pops up here. Band shrift, oops, oh, there it is right here. I think maybe it's this band shrift condensed. Let's go ahead and just use that one. Actually, I just want to go up here and just remember which font I was using. Might not be in that one, but it might be in this one. Yeah, it was band shrift, semi-condensed. So let's go ahead and make sure that that one is also semi-condensed. Let's go down to band shrift, semi-condensed, semi-bold condensed. I think that's even better. And what we're going to do is, since this is actually some text, we need to adjust the font size if we want to do that. And we need to make sure that the pin is going to be the same size or the size that we want to put it on our map. So let's go ahead and just look at this map. Let's see. Well, let's just do number 4 is Boston in our mix right here. So I'm going to go ahead and we're just going to put it right over top of Boston. So I'm going to line it up right there. And let's just see how big we're going to want these. We might want to resize them at some point after we're finished, but I'm going to go ahead and just make it a little bit smaller. And I know that this is number 4, not number 1. So I'm going to make sure the font is a little bit smaller as well. And we'll go ahead and do that. Now to change the color, I want this color to be almost the same color as the Boston color right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click, change my format shape, get to the format shape menu right here, and on the fill color, we're going to go ahead and click on our eyedropper tool, and I'm going to go ahead and hover over that Boston pin. It's that nice little orange color right there, and we're gonna go ahead and click that. Perfect. Now we want that number 4 to be black, not white, so I'm gonna go ahead and change that. And so that's how we're gonna go about adding each of these pins to the map. Now, I wanted to show you one thing. So I'm not gonna go through all of these pins. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward until I make all the pins, but I wanted you to see something. So this pin is sort of right side up. The pin is pointing there on the bottom, and the top of the pin, the rounded part, is there on the top. Now you can see in our example here, we also have some pins that are upside down. Now if you were to just copy this pin, say duplicate, Control D to duplicate, turn it upside down, you can't flip the text upside down. The text here is always going to be upside down. So what we need to do is we actually need to make a new shape. We're going to do this again. We're going to go insert icon. I'm going to go ahead and look for the location pin. I'm going to click that one, get that one here, and I'm actually going to go ahead and rotate it in this view right here when it's the icon. We're going to rotate it so it's upside down. I'm going to go ahead and say convert shape, and then we're going to go ahead and we're going to add a circle just like we did before. Make sure it's black and no outline, and we're going to put it right over top of our pin, and we're going to go ahead and union these two shapes with our merge shapes menu. And now, since this shape is now upside down, let's see if I can type into it. And I think number 2 is Jersey City here, so I'm gonna go ahead and type number 2. And now, since I made the shape from scratch that way, now this is the shape orientation that it's gonna take. So now you'll be able to type text in the upside down pin, and it will take the correct orientation there, up and down. So I'm gonna pause this video as I make the rest of the pins just like this. I'll just go ahead and show you one more time how we're going to adjust. This is Jersey City, and what I'm going to do is make sure that we are on the eyedropper tool for the fill color, and I'm going to go to that Jersey City, and it's really that nice little deep red right there. We're going to make sure that this is Bandshrift semi-condensed that we used before. Let's go down the font here and find that Bandshrift semi-bold condensed. I'm going to make this black text. We'll go to the Home tab, black text, and I'm going to make the font size a bit smaller there, because now we're going to adjust the size and make sure that it's the same size. One of the ways that you can make these shapes the same size, a little trick here, if you have downloaded that Bright Slide PowerPoint added, what we can do is we can say if this pin was the perfect size, we wanted everything to be this size, I could go ahead and select, I'm gonna select this one first, and then the last object that you select, go up to the Bright Size tab, the Bright Slide tab, and click on Match to Size. Match Size, just click on that button, and everything that you click before that last item will automatically take the size and shape of the last one that you clicked, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and pause this. We're gonna make all the pins, and I'm gonna come back when they're finished. All right, we have made all of our pins. Along the way, I came across a little issue that I wanted to just talk to you about. So in one of my pins here, when I copied over that pin, it has enough space for one number. But what about number 10? So I typed in number 10, and you can see it comes onto two lines. It kind of gets squished. If that happens to you, what I want you to do is just make sure that Format Shape menu is open. Go over to the Text Options tab, or the Text Options, it's underneath Text Options, this little sizing and properties menu. Click on that and scroll all the way down, and you can see it says Wrap Text in Shape. It's setting by default, it's saying we're gonna wrap the text in the shape. If you unselect that, it will put all the text onto one line. So go ahead and unselect that, and you can see now we have a 10, just like that 10 pin right there. So I wanted to make sure that you knew that. Now that we have all of our cities plotted, we don't need that top city map anymore. So the map with just the cities on the top, you don't have to get rid of it if you don't want to, but if you don't want to see those little red markers or those little cities there, we can go ahead and just delete that map. So I'm going to go ahead and delete it. And actually, instead of deleting it, I might just push it off to the side just in case we ever need that map again. I'm just going to push it off to the side. That's actually a pretty good thing to do. Actually, it keeps on popping back for me right there. Okay, there we go. So I'm just going to drag it off to the side just in case we would would ever need that map again, we don't have to just delete it and then recreate it. It's probably a good practice to do that. Okay, now the only other thing is I need to do little text boxes for my label. So I'm just going to go ahead and insert a text box right here. We're going to call that Boston. And you just insert that text box. And we're going to make sure that we apply the correct font to it. Vanshift, semi-condensed, bold. That's a pretty good font size, I would say. Let's make it a little bit smaller. Maybe we'll go down to 14. And then we can go ahead and just duplicate. Control D to duplicate that. We will nudge that around. We'll say this is New York. And we'll duplicate this, Control D. I'm just gonna use my arrow keys to kind of nudge it into place there. And this is like Jersey City, I think. And I'm gonna make that a little longer so everything is on one line. Number 9, let's see, what was number 9? That was Washington, D.C. And that looks like it's over there, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it on this side, and we're gonna go ahead and right align this instead of the left alignment right there. And we could go ahead and type in there, Washington, D.C. there. We'll duplicate. I think this is Arlington. And we have Miami. So it's just a little bit tedious, but you've got the time. We all do if we put our minds to it. Let's go ahead and put this one right there. Let's do San Diego. I'm going to right align this one. We'll do this, San Diego. And nudge that over just a little bit. Go ahead and duplicate it. Push this down. And let's go back over here. Once you put things off into the pasteboard, it does make it so that you have to kind of move around the slide just a little bit. Because it kind of treats the whole thing like it wants you to, the screen wants to show you everything that you have available. So once you start putting things off to the pasteboard, that can be one thing you have to always navigate to sort of zoom in here. San Francisco. I think that one's to the left, so we'll put that over one here. And then Los Angeles is right over here, and I think that's our last pin. Sweet. Los Angeles. Now, if you wanted to treat this entire thing as one grouped object, we have a whole bunch of stuff going on here. All we need to do, remember, is click and drag over the pasteboard. Make sure everything in that drag area is selected. You can see all of these little highlight boxes, all those little borders are selected. Push Control G to group, and now this entire thing is just one nice group. All right, so that was our lesson on making these map pins. Stay tuned for lesson number 8. I think we're going to go ahead and start making that really cool gradient-filled bar chart, and then we'll work with some of those custom labels on the chart in lesson number 9 and maybe number 10. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.